A very good morning, student. So let's start the chapter motion with topic equation of motion by graphical method. This topic is very important, so listen carefully how equations of motions can be derived by graphical method. We have three equations. First is velocity time relation, in which the relation between the velocity and time will be derived. The second is position time relation, in which the relation between the position and time can be derived. And third one is position velocity relation, means relation between position means s and velocity can be derived. So all these equations can be derived by simple graphical method. We take the graphical method by taking the graph between the velocity and time. In on y-axis I have taken velocity and on x-axis I have taken time. Suppose body start from the point A and changing its velocity up to this point B. So from 0 to A, velocity is initial velocity, so it is denoted by u. Listen carefully. 0 to A, it is called the initial velocity and denoted by u. And up to B means from this point to this point, this velocity is called the final velocity, so it is denoted by the v. And total time is up to C is t. Now you better know velocity units is in meter per second and time unit is in second. So to derive the first equation of motion, velocity time relation, that is v is equal to u plus at. Listen carefully. V is equal to u plus at. U is the initial velocity and v is the final velocity, and a is the acceleration and t is the time taken. Now how we can derive this equation? Simply acceleration. What is the formula of acceleration? Acceleration is equal to change in velocity per time taken. Now change in velocity, from graph you can easily see change in velocity BD means final velocity is from this point to this point, and initial velocity is this point to this point, and the change in velocity is BD, and BD is what? Final minus initial, means V minus U. So I am writing change in velocity BD, that is equal to V minus U, and time taken, that is AD. AD, that is equivalent to 0 to C, and that is time is equal to small t. So I am replacing the AD by small t. So acceleration is equal to V minus U upon t. So now this term will become AT. Multiply this term, AT is equal to V minus U. Then replace the terms, V is equal to U plus AT. So this is the first equation of motion called the velocity time relation. V is equal to U plus AT. Now the second equation of motion, position time relation. Position time relation is S is equal to UT plus half AT square. How we can derive this equation? This is a velocity time relation graph. So area under the this graph define the distance covered by the body. So we calculate the area under this graph. So first, area means distance traveled by the object is called the area. So area denotes the distance traveled. So we calculate the area so that we can calculate the distance. Means distance is the area covered by the body. So distance traveled by the object is equal to S, that is equal to area. Area means we divided the area into rectangle 0ADC rectangle and triangle ABD. Now we know the area of the rectangle 0A into 0C. Okay, and area of the triangle, that is equal to half AD into BD. So I am putting area of the rectangle 0A into 0C and area of the triangle, area of the triangle half AD into BD. So replace the 0A by U, because 0A is the initial velocity U and OC is time. Graph by graph, OC is equal to small t. So I replace OC by t and 1 by 2 AD by t, because AD and OC are equal. So AD are also replaced by t, and BD, as I already told you, BD is equal to, BD is the velocity, and velocity is equal to, means BD is equal to change in velocity, and velocity is equal to A into t. So I replace the BD by A into t. So equation becomes ut plus half a t square. So this is the second equation of motion. S is equal to ut plus half a t square. Now third equation is also very important, that is position velocity relation. Now same, the distance traveled by the body is equal to the area covered by that graph. So in earlier case, we calculate the area by taking two divisions, area of the rectangle and area of the triangle. But in this, to derive this equation, we take the area of the trapezium, that is 0ABC. Okay? In earlier case, we have taken two areas, but in this equation, I have taken the total area of the trapezium, 0ABC. Now, area of the trapezium, S is equal to area of the trapezium. Area of the trapezium formula is sum of the parallel side and distance between the two parallel side. So 0A plus BC. 0A plus BC. 0A means initial velocity and BC is equal to final velocity. So replace the 0A, OA plus BC by U plus V and OC by OC. OC is the time. So we replace the OC by T, okay? OA plus BC, U plus V and OC by T, and we have already 2. So, now replace the T by, from first equation of motion, replace the T by V minus U by A, okay? Because A is equal to V minus U by T. So, if we replace the T above and A below. So, T is equal to V minus U upon A. So, here we replace the T by V minus U upon A. Clear? I am repeating again. We have V plus U upon 2 into T, but we replace the T by velocity upon acceleration. Okay? Clear? Now, we know the formula A plus B, A minus P is equal to A square minus B square. So, A minus B, A plus B is equal to A square minus B square, means V square minus U square by 2A. Now, on the other side, we have capital S, means distance, it means position. Okay? So, now replace the term 2A above 2, multiply that S by 2A, then we have 2A, S is equal to V square minus U square. This is the third equation of motion called the position velocity relation. Okay, in this lecture we have derived the all three equations. First equation was velocity time, in which we have V is equal to U plus AT. In second equation we have position time relation. We have S is equal to UT plus half AT square. And in third equation, we have position velocity relation. That is equal to 2AS is equal to V square minus U square. Thank you. And do the numerical on same these equations.